Hey guys, I feel like it's been forever and a day since I last filmed a beauty related video. I've been more into fashion recently and kind of neglected my beauty side. Today I'm gonna show you guys the products that I have used up and some new products that I recently purchased. So let's start with the empties. I've used up my Ritual of Anahata shower foam. This is absolutely fantastic. I have a new bottle of this waiting for me at home. It was a limited edition collection. I don't know if it's still available because it was released around Christmas time. It's rosewood and pine scent, and oh my god, I became completely obsessed with this line. I have a body scrub, body lotion, these shower foams, tea from this line. I just love it all. It smells so nice. And I'm not a fan of rose, but it's rosewood. So it's like, it still has that rosy scent, but it's woodsy at the same time. Go give it a sniff. And one thing that I can recommend from Rituals is these shower foams. They're absolutely amazing. So basically it's like gel when you squirt it out and then it foams up. This is also perfect for shaving. So I use it instead of a shaving mousse. I mean, love, love, love it. Another shower product I've used up is Pupa Milk Lovers Shower Milk. So this is oat milk and vanilla scented one. And wow, this scent. The body butter is absolutely incredible. I love it more than the shower milk. It was nice. I wasn't a huge fan of the texture. It was too runny. I wish it was a little bit thicker, but the smell, oh my god. Yeah, check it out if you're into kind of sweet vanilla-y scents. A product I haven't used up, but I hate it so much, I'm just gonna get rid of it, is from L'Erbolario, which is a beautiful Italian brand. Actually, they do amazing soaps. They do lots of things like skincare, fragrance, I believe. So this is their micellar water. It says cleansing and moisturizing for sensitive and hyperreactive skin. So I do get it. It's like super mild, gentle, and it's kind of slippery, but it doesn't remove makeup properly. Like, I hate it. I have half of it left. I was trying to use it up, but it just kind of, it just moves the makeup on your face and it doesn't take it off, and I just cannot deal with that. I would rather use Bioderma's micellar water or like some other brand, but please don't get this one. Some other skincare empties. This is Origins Ginseng Refreshing Eye Cream to Brighten and Depuff. Love this eye cream. It's definitely my favorite eye cream. I have a new pot that I'm currently using. I use it in the mornings because it's super brightening. It's this like pink illuminating cream and it's infused with shimmery particles, so it's almost like highlighter for under your eyes. I wouldn't say it's really depuffing. I have a tendency to have puffy eyes, especially in the morning, or if I don't drink enough of water or eat something salty, I will wake up with like huge puffy eyes. So this doesn't work. It doesn't really reduce puffiness, but it's super brightening, super illuminating. If you are tired, didn't get enough of sleep, just apply this and it's just gonna brighten your eyes. So yeah, love it, absolutely love it. As I said, I have a new pot, would definitely always repurchase it. It's like my staple product. I've used up Lancôme Hydra Zen Mask. This is anti-stress moisturizing overnight serum in mask. Loved this stuff, but I had only a tiny travel size one. This one actually came in my Lancôme advent calendar. I would just slather it on my face at night over my moisturizer and go to sleep, and you wake up with like such hydrated skin. It's a very hydrating product. So if you have dehydrated skin or your skin's like dull and tired, I feel like this is an amazing, amazing overnight mask. Okay, what else? I finished my Dior lip glow. This is actually my second one. While I can still scrape some of it out, yeah, it's a great lip balm. I've used it for a long time now. It has a minty scent, which is very nice. I've heard that mint is actually an irritant to your lips and you shouldn't use anything minty or lemony on your lips, but Yeah, I don't know, it doesn't really irritate my lips. It's a lip balm that supposedly adapts to the pH in your lips and turns a different shade of pink on everyone. I feel like it turns the exact same shade of pink on everyone. It's quite a bright pink and it's very brightening. You know, like on some days your lips can look very colorless. Just apply this lip balm and it's just gonna instantly bring out life and color in your lips. And they recently released many more colors, like lilac color, peachy color, darker rosy colors. So I think there's a shade for everyone now, and this is just a universal number one. Yeah, I would buy it again, and I love Dior, so. Okay, moving on to some makeup bits. I finished my Maybelline Superstay 24 Hour Full Coverage Foundation. Had it in number three, True Ivory. Love this foundation. I've raved about it so many times. I've recommended it to a lot of people in real life. Super inexpensive and yet such a great drugstore foundation. It's very high coverage, so perfect for photo shoots, for filming. When you just want to look flawless, if you have some imperfections, it covers everything, but it doesn't look cakey at all. So love, love, love it. Would repurchase it. Finished my Dior, what is this called? Dior Show Brow Styler. So I had it in, this is so strange, I had it in the color 21 Chestnut. And this is not a color I would normally go for. I would go for like taupe or blonde. So I'm surprised that Chestnut was a perfect shade for me. And it, you know, it's completely gone, so I cannot show you. It's a retractable pencil. It's super skinny. It's like a perfect dupe for Anastasia Brow Wiz. I mean, shouldn't call it a dupe because it's pretty much the same price point. But yeah, they're super similar, like retractable, super skinny pencil and a fantastic spoolie on the other end for combing through your eyebrows. And yeah, adore this pencil, so definitely repurchasing it. It's my favorite along with Anastasia Brow Wiz. Another brow product I loved is Eylure Brow Amplifier in Blonde, which is just a tinted eyebrow gel. My subscriber Laiz kindly sent it to me and I love this. I mean, I use tinted eyebrow gels every single day. So what I do, I would just use this all over my brows just to fill them in. And then I would take this skinny pencil and just define the tail of my brow, elongate my eyebrow a little bit. So that's literally all I do. And I might add a little bit of, you know, a few strokes at the front of my brows. But yeah, this is like my everyday brow routine, a tinted brow gel and a pencil. And at the moment I'm using Givenchy Mr. Brow Groom or something. Can't remember what it's called. But yeah, this one is a great one as well from Eylure. Okay, then I finished ROCS toothpaste sensational whitening. Didn't like it at all. It had some granules in it and it wasn't minty enough. Didn't whiten my teeth. I mean, didn't like this toothpaste at all, so would not buy it again. I finished my Lahons Eclat Minute Instant Light Lip Balm Perfector. I adore these. I think Lahons, they do the best lip balms, or like kind of beautifying lip balms. It's like a lip gloss, lip balm, tinted lip balm kind of thing. So this one was in number six, Rosewood, which is like a nude color. I tried scraping it out. This is the color. So it's like a perfect everyday nude color. It's very sheer, so it's like a tinted lip balm. I think the name is very accurate. It's called Instant Light because it definitely has something. It gives, it's almost like highlighting your lips. It gives light and brightness and plumpness and glossiness to your lips, and it's not sticky at all. I love these, and they come in so many different colors. And I also finished this one in nude in like a tube form. I've gone through, I think, three of the ones in the tube, and I actually repurchased one. I'm gonna show you in a minute. But yeah, love them. Highly, highly recommend Lahons lip balms in a stick or in a tube. They're absolutely fantastic. And then lastly, I finished my Gizou honey-infused hair oil by Negin Mirsaleh. She's one of my favorite bloggers, influencers. I love her style so much. Her hair is incredible. So yeah, I thought I'm gonna support Negin and purchase her hair oil. And it's ridiculously expensive. I think it's 74 euros. You get 100 milliliters. But I really liked it. It lasted me quite a while. One thing I didn't like was the pipette. I think I've heard a lot of people complain it doesn't work. It doesn't work properly, it doesn't pick up the oil well. So I think Negin should change the quality of the pipette. Other than that, I think the oil is amazing, especially for my hair. It's very fine, soft, kind of slippy, lightweight hair. And to me, this oil was perfect because it didn't weight my hair down. A lot of products do that, and it just, my hair just feels dirty and lifeless and too heavy. It doesn't, it loses bounce and flow. But this oil, it just, I could layer it over and over and it would not do that. It tames flyaways and it adds a lot of shine. Like, your hair is so glowy after, so if you want that, if you want a lightweight oil, shine and something to tame your frizz, this is the perfect oil for you. Would I repurchase it? Probably, but definitely not from her website. She charges 25 euros for shipping to Lithuania, which I think is ridiculous. If shipping was free, I would purchase many more of her products, her new hair mask, texturizing spray, heat protectant, but I just cannot justify. I mean, this plus shipping price would equal 100 euros, which is crazy. And the ingredients are super similar to Moroccan oil. So I like both of the oils equally. I think Moroccan oil light and Negin's oil, I love them both. I cannot tell which one is my favorite. And as I said, ingredients are quite similar. But I like the fact that I can support a blogger who started her own company instead of one big, you know, company. I think that's very important that girls support other girls. So yeah, I would repurchase Gizou oil and would recommend it to you guys. However, it's not a natural oil, so do keep that in mind. If you're looking for something natural, this is not for you. Okay, now let's move on to the exciting part, the new in products. So speaking about Rituals shower gels, I purchased this one, which I haven't tried before. It's called Yogi Flow. It's Indian rose and sweet almond oil, and I think it's gonna be amazing. Smells really good. Smells very sweet, and the rose is not too dominant, which I really like. It's more almondy, I would say. So yeah, excited to start using this one. I'm gonna mention a couple of products that you guys already saw in my vlog videos, but I know that not everyone watches my vlog videos, so if you haven't seen my vlog with Auxe, I'm gonna show these products to you here as well. So purchase some Dior products. This one is Dior Skin Nude Air Tan Powder in number one, which is a bronzer I wanted for a very long time. So I finally purchased it because it was a little bit discounted and I thought it's a great time to purchase it. It comes with a cute little kabuki brush, but I don't like using bronzers with a kabuki brush because I feel like it looks too dense. Like, I like a big fluffy brush for bronzer to make it look more natural. This is not for me. So yeah, this is what it looks like. I don't know, I really like it. It's a great bronzer, it's matte. And how beautiful is this packaging? I love it. It's actually metal, so it's very heavy. And then I also purchased this Dior Show Fusion Mono Longwear eyeshadow in number one, Lune, which means moon in French. And it is basically like a pearl color, like a white, shimmery white cream eyeshadow. Looks like pearl basically. And this is what I have in my inner corners today. And I feel like it's a perfect eyeshadow for that inner corner highlight. I always like to have highlight in my inner corner. I feel like it brightens and opens up your eyes, so this is perfect for that. You can layer it on your other eyeshadows, and like, it looks very pretty on like neutral nude shadows. It just adds that, you know, like shimmer and glow. So a lot of bloggers that I follow are working on the campaign for this By Terry mascara. I've seen so many people talk about it, rave about this mascara, so I went into Creme de la Creme shop here in Klaipeda and I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna get this mascara and see for myself if it's really that magical. And I love it. It's a Lash Expert Twist Brush mascara with double effect. So you have two steps. You just twist the cap. So I do step one, and the wand looks like this. It has short plastic bristles, and this is exactly the type of wand that I like. And then you twist the cap to number two, and what it does, it twists the brush. Look, can you guys see how it has twisted? So this step is supposed to add volume. So first step is length, second step is volume, and I love step one because I'm all about length, you guys know that. So I get a lot of length with that, and then I do step two to add a little bit of volume. And today I didn't even use my Dior eyelash primer, which you also know I love. I feel like this mascara on its own is enough for me. I love the result. It's not clumpy. It's like what I want in a mascara, and I really, really like it. Would highly recommend it. Money well spent, I would say. Something that I was actually sent when I got back from Paris, this was waiting for me. It's Estee Lauder Advanced Night Repair, and I was stoked when I saw this. I was like, oh my god. I had really problematic skin. I had lots of spots, and I didn't know how to get rid of them. And I remember I started watching Tania Burr. She was new on YouTube. It was her first videos as well. She was raving about Estee Lauder's Advanced Night Repair, and also Chloe Morello. She did, I think, a whole video on this product or her skincare routine or something. She also had acne, and she said this product is a miracle. So I was like, okay, I need to save up all my money and purchase this product. It was really expensive. It still is a very expensive serum. I think you can see me using it in my YouTube videos. It didn't really treat my spots because it is not a spot treatment, and I was disappointed. I was like, it didn't heal my skin. My spots are still here. I spent so much money. But I feel like this was not what I needed at that time. So, I kind of forgot about the serum. I didn't purchase it again. And when I saw that PR sent me the serum, I was like, that is amazing. So I started using it. So I've been using it for like a week now, a little over a week. And oh my god, it is fantastic. It is a serum for all skin types. It's supposed to be super hydrating. So I think the main premise is hydration, plumpness. It's so moisturizing. This is all I use at night now. I don't even apply moisturizer. I just use this serum. Can you guys see the texture? It's like kind of thick, plump kind of serum. It's I cannot really explain the texture to you guys, and I don't like the smell of it. Yeah, I remember that smell. It's kind of herbal. But oh my god, my skin drinks it up. It feels so amazing. My skin feels really good at the moment. I don't have any new spots. It looks clear. It feels hydrated. I don't have any dry patches or flakiness. And oh my god, I love this stuff so much. So I'm really thankful to Estee Lauder for it. Okay, I got some new nail polishes. I got these in Paris, actually. So I love Mavala. It's one of my favorite nail polish brands. And when I'm in Paris, I often tend to purchase Mavala there because they have a crazy good selection in Monoprix. So these I got at Opera Monoprix store. I think they have a crazy good selection of Mavala polishes there. At the moment, I'm really into purple and orange. So I got this lilac one. I think this is their new shade. It's called Reykjavik. I had this on in Paris. Such a beautiful lilac color. I used to hate purple and lilac on my nails because I have very warm skin tone, and these are cool colors. So it kind of clashes, but I don't know, just love the colors on their own. I got this one called Samarkand. It's like a deep bright purple. And this is the one I have on my nails right now. It's an orange called Jaipur. I need a little bit of a tan to pull this off. And then at the airport, I purchased this Essie nail polish in Eternal Optimist. I've wanted to try this color for a long time. I love this shade of pink. I got it. I was like, yeah, this is my color. I'm getting it. But then I realized that it's pretty much the dupe to my beloved Sally Hansen Ping Pong. They're pretty much the exact same color. But it just shows that I gravitate towards colors like this. So yeah, Eternal Optimist, I love the name, and it lasts so long on your nails. I had it on last week. Amazing lasting power. Oh, this is actually not the last beauty product. Totally forgot. So yeah, as I said, I repurchased Clahone's Instant Light Natural Lip Perfector in a tube form. And I got it, so I had number one, which is pink, number two, a peach color, and number three, like a nude one, but they released more colors. So I got number four now, which is called Petal Shimmer. I don't know, it's just like a peachy pink color. So this is a brand new one, I'm so excited. It comes with like a sponge applicator, and I use it as lip balm because it just makes your lips look so good. Always have to have one of these in my collection. Yeah, I totally forgot. I purchased some essentials, but I showed you guys all the exciting products, and now I'm gonna show you the boring essentials. Repurchased my favorite toothpaste, which if you care to know, it's Colgate Max White Luminous Venus Sensitive Pink Razors. Dove Soap Bar, because this is what I use to wash my brushes and my beauty blender. Best thing ever, always Dove Soap Bar. So my hands at the moment are extremely dry and nothing helps. All my nice scented hand creams, they're just not strong enough and they don't fix my hands. Like the hand cream sinks in and then an hour later my hands still look extremely dry. So I got Mixa Intensive Care. This is actually formulated under medical supervision, so I thought I need a medical strength hand cream. It's 15% glycerin and oat milk. Intensive repair effect, ideal for winter, non-oily, paraben, alcohol-free. So I was like, this is what I need. So yeah, I really hope it's gonna work. That's everything I got. I know that's like a lot of new in, but it was super fun for me to film a beauty related video. If you guys would like to see more beauty hauls in the future, please give it a thumbs up and let me know in the comments. Have a great day. Love you loads, and I'll see you very soon. Bye.